Hello everyone, and welcome back to another hot sauce video. Today in the mail I got the July box for hot ones from Heatonist. We're gonna go ahead and get this unboxed, and we're gonna try all three sauces. I'm gonna let you know what I think of them. I've heard there's supposed to be some pretty good ones in this month's box, so we're just gonna go ahead and get this open. Here's our two stickers. So there's a Heatonist sticker here, and I think that's supposed to be Sean from the show. We'll, don't really know if it wants to focus on that. But yeah, there we go. So there's our two stickers. We have our little guide here telling us what is in this month's box. And again, here are the three bottles for this month. So looks like we have the classic Garlic Fresno edition. Not sure what that middle one is. And then Hellfire Detroit hot sauce as well. So we're going to start off with basically going left to right. We're going to start with the blue one first, which is the Hot Ones Classic Garlic Fresno Edition. And according to this little guide, it says, the newest Hot Ones recipe featuring organic Fresno chilies straight from Smokin' Ed's farm. What's that? While Fresnos haven't become as prolific as jalapeno, chefs often prize them for their sweet, subtly earthy flavor. We love the depth they add when paired with a big hit of garlic, bringing a wonderful dose of umami. Use the classic Garlic Fresno edition like you would sriracha on everything. Unlike sriracha, this recipe includes no added sugar, so you can feel good about drowning your eggs in it, mixing it with yogurt for a spicy spread, brushing it on wings, topping stir-fry. Possibilities are endless as the garlic flavor. So we're going to go ahead and try that. So here's the bottle there. So, classic. Let's see what else. Let's see if there's any ingredient listed here. So, ingredients on this say it's Fresno chilies, Fresno chili pepper, water, apple cider vinegar, garlic, garlic puree, garlic and water, vinegar, kosher salt, organic dried garlic, organic turmeric, organic black pepper. So, go ahead and get that shaken up. And then get the label peeled off here. All right, there we go. Gonna grab just a slice of this bread here. Has a pretty good smell to it. Let's see what the consistency is like. So, pretty good consistency as well. Got some just on the bread there. Okay, got a little bit of heat from the Fresno pepper. So, not super spicy, but pretty good tasting. Has good flavor. A little bit heat. Definitely more than the, I think the mild sauce last month was the Jade Jaguar. That didn't have a whole lot of heat, but had pretty good flavor. This has a little bit more heat, and the flavor is pretty good, too. So, again, that is the classic. So, I think they've done a few of these classics before. I think there's, like, a red one and stuff like that. This is the first one I've got where I've gotten an actual one of the classics in the box. But this is the classic Garlic Fresno edition by Heatonist for Hot Ones. So that one is pretty good. Like, just like a little bit of heat, not a ton of it. Definitely more than some of the more mild ones they've done lately. Sounds pretty good. Just get the flavor of that off of, out of my mouth so I don't really taint the flavor of the next one. Which is... Let me grab the card here. So second one is the Shaquanda's Spicier Smoke. So as you might recognize the maker from Season 9, when Shaquanda's hot pepper sauce became a fan favorite, Andre the Maker is back with a version of his OG sauce that packs more of a punch thanks to added habanero. Spicier Smoke has all the island flavors of the original, pungent onion flavor, tangy mustard, sweetness from the peppers, but with 2x the heat and a kiss of smoke from paprika powder. A must-have for summer cooking. Try it on fish, roasted cauliflower, breakfast hash, and more. So here's that one. And I definitely recognize the logo. Like, I think I've seen that before, like, on some of the episodes, the older ones. Then let's take a look at the ingredients here. Let's see where they're at. Nutritional facts. All right, so here's the ingredients. So it says onion, white distilled vinegar, chili powder, roasted red pepper, red wine vinegar, grape must, lemon juice, salt, sugar, but what's this? Mustard powder, turmeric, and smoked paprika. Go ahead and try to get this open. It has a pretty good smell to it. Grab this. It's all shaken up. We're just going to add a little bit to here. Alright, there we go. Alright, so there's definitely kind of like a immediate surge of heat. It's not insane, but it's definitely pretty hot. I've definitely had hotter, but this is like that's got a good heat right away. Good flavor as well. That's definitely a good one. Definitely kind of like a good like intermediate heat, I think. So it's not mild and it's not super hot like some of the other ones. Like the Thor's Hammer is probably my favorite one that they've released so far. And that was just insanely hot. Like, really good flavor, really good heat. This is really good heat, really good flavor, and the kind of heat's kind of like in the middle. So, definitely pretty good. We're going to move on to our last sauce. And the final sauce for the July box is the Hellfire Detroit Cabernet Habanero Reaper. So, according to this, it says, who would have thought that the purist who brought us Hellfire Detroit Habanero could create such a complex sauce? Made with fire-roasted habaneros and Carolina Reapers, the star of this sauce is Cabernet Sauvignon? I'm not sure how I'm pronouncing that. Yeah, they just call it Cab Sauv, so the wine. Cabernet Sauvignon, I believe. So the wine, which brings fruit-driven notes to echo the sweetness of the Reapers. Capers provide a salty pop, while roasted red pepper adds sweet, smoky depth. Savor it like a fine wine and pair with steak, grill portobellos, and cheese of all types. So here's the bottle for that one. The Hellfire Detroit. Let's see what our ingredient list is here. So ingredients are Cabernet Sauvignon wine, fire-roasted red bell pepper, fire-roasted habanero, red wine vinegar, water, tomato paste, olives, onion, non-perilous capers. So I guess capers, I'm not sure what the non-perilous part means. Garlic, sea salt, Carolina Reaper peppers, olive oil, naturally occurring citric acid, and may contain sulfites. So give it a shake. Kind of getting a little bit of a burning nose in the last sauce. Get that shaken up, and let's go ahead and get it open. Grab those scissors again. Alright, there we go. Actually even wants to come off. Let's see here. Yep, there we go. Just open it like that. Peel that off. Alright. smells pretty good. Red. Alright, here we go. Looks like it's a little bit like a thicker sauce than the others. That might be too much, but let's go ahead and give it a shot. This does have Carolina Reaper in it, so it's probably going to be pretty hot. Not really getting the heat right now. Oh, there's the heat. It's just kicked in. So yeah, Carolina Reaper kind of like, the heat is kind of delayed, so it was, took a few seconds, but yeah, definitely really, really hot. That is, yes, quite spicy. I really like anything with Carolina Reaper. Carolina Reaper is probably one of my favorite peppers right now. I haven't had it on its own, just have like a raw Carolina Reaper. I would definitely try one time. If I can find them. But definitely a big fan of the Carolina Reaper sauces, and this is another pretty good one. Again, I still think Thor's Hammer is my favorite one that had that. Thor's Hammer and Brain Burner are like my two favorites. But this one is pretty good as well. It doesn't quite have the flavor of those other two, the Brain Burner and the Thor's Hammer. The flavor is not quite as good as that, but the heat is, again, the heat's a little less spicy, because I think Thor's Hammer included just like a ton of different like peppers. But this one is pretty hot and pretty good. Kind of like a step below those other two. But definitely three good sauces this month. I like the, probably my favorite one, I'm probably going to say probably the Classic. The Classic is just like a, not super hot, but it's got like a lot of good flavor. And then my second favorite is probably this and then this. These are all actually like really good. Like I think this month I didn't have one that I didn't really care for. Usually every month there's one sauce that is just kind of alright. This month it looks like they've actually got three really good sauces in it. So definitely a successful box. I remember like I think in March it had Eye of the Scorpion, which I've talked about before, where I just didn't like that and that felt like it was kind of like the weak link in that box, and maybe the February one. I just finished it, I finally got rid of it, or finally finished a bottle up of what's it called? Widowmaker? Widowmaker was an alright sauce, but I finished it. I don't think I will ever finish the bottle of Eye of the Scorpion. But yeah, every month there's one that I kind of don't care for. This month, these are all three pretty good. So definitely, probably as far as like the number of successful bottles this month, probably the best month that they've done. I think. Like I think there was like usually once a month there's one I don't care for, but these are all really good. So that's gonna do it for this video. Remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe. We'll see you next time. Thanks again for watching, and take care.